But he was so angry I had gotten away. He just drove somewhere else and killed someone else.
Deborah Kent was attending a play with Yuman High School. She left the play early to pick up her brother. Debbie never got to her car.
The same night that Carol Durant was kidnapped, Debbie Kent was abducted in a parking lot north of Salt Lake. Found in the parking lot was a handcuff key.
And the key fit my handcuff that I had had on me.
Police believe the key was from the same handcuffs used to kidnap Carol Durant. 4 hours earlier, the same night, Debbie Kent disappeared.
Now, there's a witness and real evidence. The police are starting to make connections.
It had been a number of months, and we had run out of leads to pursue for the missing women in the state of Washington. So sometimes you have to rely on people who might, by circumstance, find something.
I got a call from a friend in the police department. He said, get your butt up to Taylor Mountain. I said, what's going on? He said, just go. So I went up there with some of the Seattle homicide detectives, and they told me that they had found bodies.
It was a group of student foresters marking trees on Taylor Mountain, and they found the skull of Brenda Ball laying in the woods. They called the sheriff's office, and we began a search ourselves with our own search and rescue volunteers, and we discovered 100 feet apart the remains of three other women. It was pretty much of a nightmare.
We keep finding more and more every day. You get in that woods and you just don't know what's in there. It's so thick and so overgrown with bushes that you could find anything, you know, a couple hours from now or 5 minutes from now. It doesn't matter.
About the Taylor Mountain.
At the Taylor Mountain, the crime scene?
We can make a reasonable guess that this individual was clearly trying to cover up his crimes.